All right, welcome back to the channel. I want to go over clip attributes. When you click on a piece of media when navigating to your storage location, you can get the metadata from it, but you can't actually start manipulating the media until you've dragged it into a bin into your media pool. So here I've brought some clips in, and now we could preview this clip from our media bin, and the inspector over here is now active. So if you wanted to zoom a shot in, or for this demonstration, I will soften the edges. So it's obvious. You can do that prior to working with your media or adding anything into your timeline. This might be applicable if you have a bunch of shots that need the same LUT and you have them all grouped by camera. You could just highlight them, right click, you could add a LUT or do some global things like that. And they're all in a decent color space prior to working with the footage. There's a few caveats to that. So let's jump over to the edit page and I'll show you what I mean. So here, if we click on this same shot that I added the soft edging to, you can see in the preview monitor, it's got the soft edges. Now, if we drag it down to our timeline or edit it in, it still has the soft cropping. And if we leave that alone and we use it again, it's always going to have that. Now that it's in the timeline, though, if we were to reset it, it can go back. But if we look at our clip here in the preview monitor, you can see it still retains the soft image. You can't go back and reverse that and do it globally from the media bin. You have to do it per clip on the timeline. Now you can right click on any of these clips here and it has a clip attribute. And you can do that from the timeline as well. And these things also have some caveats that don't carry over. So if you were to rename the shot, change the frame rate, some of these things carry over. So if I flip this image in the media bin and hit OK, it's going to flip in the timeline. Now, if we open that back up again and reverse that, let's go to the name and we'll just rename this clip. Now it actually renames on the timeline and on the clip. But if we click here on the clip and we have clip attributes down here at the bottom this time, we can rename this to, we'll just call it waterfall this time. You can see the clip renamed in the timeline, but the clip inside the media bin that it's pointing to stayed water. And you can also verify that by right clicking your clip here and you could say find in media pool. And if it wasn't already selected, it would highlight that clip. So that's one of those features where you have to know when to use it and when it's going to change it or not. Now you can, if you have your double viewer up and you double click your source and timeline. So let's open that. So on the left is our source viewer. So any piece of like media we're previewing, and then on the right is our timeline. We double click in there. We have the soft edging like we put on over in the media page. You can actually hit the three dot menu here and say reset video. And then you could see the preview window reset as well as the thumbnail in your media pool. Now there's also clip attributes that are clip based on the timeline itself. So let's take this waterfall shot. You can see it's got a little bit of a zoom, but let's zoom it in further. So let's drag this clip down. So you can see this one isn't zoomed out and the first clip is zoomed in. If we grab here, we can hit Command C and copy. And if we were to hit Command V, it would just paste the clip. But if we select the destination clip and hit Option V, that pops up a clip attributes dialog box. And you can also right click here. It's at the top, you get clip attributes. So now that's saying from waterfall MP4, and it's breaking it down into whether you wanted to manipulate the video or the audio track. What do you want to paste? It recognizes that a zoom has been done and that we have a plugin. I'll hit apply. So now if we click on that next clip, it has the shared zoom. But that's another thing. If you wanted to add plugins like this blur here, I'm just using that so it's obvious. You can see now it has the effect applied because it has effects in the bottom left of the clip. We're going to hit Command C again, choose the next clip, Option V. Plugins is highlighted. So if there is any, it'll copy over. We hit apply. And now the second clip also has the plugin applied. And then you can go back after the fact, just like any other clip, and change or adjust parameters or delete them. So it's still an independent clip, But if you noticed a sizing change and you wanted to crop something out, you could just do it from the attributes and copy it to all those clips. That's a faster way than going through and having to hunt down each clip. And this applies for audio as well. So if you wanted to do like voice isolation on dialogue tracks, let's say you had a noisy environment, you could do it on the clip level before you add it into the timeline and have that done ahead of time. Now, one thing that does carry over is your LUTs. So let's go ahead and convert this to a DCI color space. And you'll see it turns lavender and sort of washed out looking. And you noticed our preview window updated, our timeline window updated, media pool thumbnail updated as well. So you can globally change a LUT if you needed to. All right. I hope that helps. Thanks for watching as always. And I'll see you guys on the next video.